And I am ready to go toe-to-toe with Senator McCain whenever and wherever he desires.
She and John McCain are very close. They always laughed that if they wound up being the nominees of their party, it would be the most civilized election in American history, and they're afraid they'd put the voters to sleep because they like and respect each other.
And now, with Senator McCain as the likely Republican nominee, the Republicans have chosen more of the same. President Bush has already put his stamp of approval on Senator McCain's conservative credentials.
She did tell the book author that she thought Hillary Clinton would be the Democratic nominee.
I did. I do. I think she's a very formidable candidate. And one of the interesting things that she brings is that she has been under pressure. She understands the Klieg lights.
I mean, I've heard him say that several times,
right,
in the White House in off-the-record situations. You know, now that he's saying it, I guess we're all free to talk about it. My sense when he talks about this is that there is a president's club that he feels she has proved that she's worthy of belonging to. He's comfortable with her position on Iraq. Obviously, I don't think he cares what Democrats think about that, but that's the key piece of the strategy, right, of his legacy for him.
I understand there are some people who say they can't tell the difference between me and George Bush. Well, I don't think anyone here believes that the Republicans are confusing me and George Bush. And certainly, having fought George Bush every day for the last 7 years, I will be among those most happy to finally see the moving van leaving the White House.
Two of my dad's favorite people, me and President Clinton.
When you're the best of friends, having so much fun together, you're not even aware you're such a funny pair. You're the best of friends. Life's a happy game. You could clown around forever.
Read my lips. No new taxes.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman, Miss Lewinsky. I never told anybody to lie, not a single time, never.
Neither one of you sees your natural boundaries. Life's one happy game. If only the world wouldn't get in the way.
What is at stake is more than one small country. It is a big idea. A new world order.
President Bush said, and it was a phrase that I often use myself, that we needed a new world order.
If only people would just let you play, they say you're both being fools. You're breaking all the rules.